All I could do was to offer you an opinion upon one minor point. A woman must have money and a room of her own if she is to write fiction. And that, as you will see, leaves the grave problem of the true nature of woman and the true nature of fiction unsolved. Virginia Woolf grew up in London in a prosperous literary household. Many of the great figures of the Victorian literary scene frequented her parents' home. Although her brothers were afforded educations at Cambridge, the girls of the family were not. Woolf did take some courses at the Ladies' College of King's College, London. Woolf's mother died unexpectedly when she was 13, and one of her half-sisters died 2 years later. These events precipitated the first of several mental breakdowns that Woolf experienced. She suffered from depression and anxiety, and many biographers state that she had bipolar disorder. Her father died when she was 22, and she was briefly institutionalized because of another breakdown. Her nephew and biographer, Quentin Bell, suggests that her mental difficulties were caused by childhood sexual abuse perpetrated by one of her half-brothers. After their father's death, Virginia's sister Vanessa and brother Adrian bought a house in the Bloomsbury area of London. This house became the center of a group of artists and writers known as the Bloomsbury Group.
Virginia married Leonard Woolf in 1912. Together they started the Hogarth Publishing Company, which published work by T.S. Eliot and Catherine Mansfield, as well as Woolf's own works. Woolf did much of her writing in this summer house in the garden of Monk's House in Rodmell.
Virginia and Leonard Woolf bought Monk's House in 1919 as a country retreat. And like their house in Bloomsbury, it soon became a center for the literati. At the outbreak of World War II, the couple were living here at Monk's House when they received news that their home in London had been destroyed in an air raid. Because Leonard was Jewish, they had a plan, actually a suicide pact, in case the Germans did in fact invade England during World War II. Said, "Dearest, I feel certain I am going mad again, and I shan't recover this time." Virginia Woolf filled her coat pockets with rocks and walked off in that direction toward the River Ouse, where she drowned herself.
Her husband buried Virginia Woolf's cremated remains in the garden of Monk's House at Broadmoor.